Consider a segment AB. How would the perpendicular bisector of this segment look? As the name says, it has to be perpendicular and it has to bisect the segment. Let line L be the perpendicular bisector of this segment and say it intersects AB at point C. This will be a right angle. And length of AC will equal length of BC. The perpendicular bisector of a segment divides that segment into two equal parts and is also perpendicular to it. Let's erase this and look at perpendicular bisectors in a triangle. Consider triangle PQR. If we draw a perpendicular bisector of each side of a triangle, in all, we will have three of them. The angle bisectors of all the angles of a triangle always meet at a point. But do the perpendicular bisectors of the sides of a triangle also meet at a single point? Let line L be the perpendicular bisector of segment PQ. These two sides will be equal and this will be a right angle. Let line M be the perpendicular bisector of side QR. That will make these two sides equal and this angle a right angle. Now we have to see if the perpendicular bisector of segment PR passes through this point. Let line N be the perpendicular bisector of segment PR, and yes, it passes through the same point. This side will equal this side and line N will be perpendicular to PR. So even the perpendicular bisectors of the triangle meet at point C, one single point. What is this point called? It's called the circumcenter. We had seen that the incenter of the triangle will always lie inside the triangle. But does the circumcenter always lie inside the triangle? We see that in the next part of the video.